welcome to On the Move. Is it possible to sum up life in 6 words? Our On the Move guest, Jason Pichetti, diagnosed with ALS, chose these words: speech and movement compromised, spirit unaffected. Jason wants us to know how he is coping with ALS, a neurodegenerative disease affecting the nerve cells that control muscle movement. Now our On the Move host, Donna Yeager, meets with Jason and Famine Pichetti as they tell about Jason's amazing family and friends that have and continue to provide endless support and encouragement.
Hi, I'm Donna Yeager with On the Move, and I'd like to welcome our guests, Jason and Famine Pichetti. Welcome.
Hi.
Your blog that you do is so amazing, and it's so interesting because really your intelligence is so phenomenal that really it comes through on the blog.
Yes. Well, unfortunately, even though with ALS your body betrays you, your mind is completely sharp.
Yeah, exactly.
And Jason is the most intelligent person I know. That's where the attraction was, definitely. Oh, Emma, no, our daughter is the most intelligent person. I'm sorry. And he's so smart. I'm the English teacher, but his writing is amazing. He's always been a gifted writer. He's actually in the process of writing a memoir, a book of fatherly advice for our daughter.
Oh, cool.
So he's working on that a little bit, along with his blog.
Oh,
so, but he
has
fans from all over.
Cool.
We call the ALS the ALSA to get some advice for some services and things like that. And when I said his name, the woman says, "Is that ALS Boy?" Like she knew who he was. She reads his blog entries out to people, to her entire staff before a meeting for inspiration. All the kids read it at school. It's amazing.
Your family is very important, and they've been able to help out a lot, right?
Very much so. His family lived in San Bruno, in a house in San Bruno for, when Jason was one, they moved in, so about 40 years. And when they found out he was sick and I was pregnant, they, without hesitation, said, "Okay, we're going to sell our place and let's buy a home together." And all of us are living together. Although it's difficult, it's not the most ideal situation. Hint, hint. It is, however, a huge support for us. Not all parents would do that. That was a huge sacrifice on their end to sell their house and live with us and take care of our baby. And they're both retired, too.
Wow.
So this is their retirement that they're, you know. Oh, my family. Oh, my family is extremely supportive as well. I forgot about my family. They live in the East Bay, and they help all the time. My brother comes and hangs out with him, and my sisters are over. My parents come over. Very all around. We have great family, and they all live in the area, which is
lucky.
Wonderful.
Yeah.
Yes. Yes. Because ALS requires extensive care. Extensive. And I work full-time, and, you know, you don't want to overburden just one person.
You
really want to spread it out and have a network of friends to help. We both work at the same school at La Entrada. So we have a network of friends there who have known Jason before ALS
and now.
And they've been there through thick and thin.
Wow.
They even started a catastrophic leave bank at our school, and the teachers each donated sick days from their own bank. And that was able to carry Jason with full salary for an entire year, even though he wasn't working. We have we have our own insurance, but because they're not essentially kind of on a clinic model, they authorized for us to go for a first visit to the ALS clinic. And our doctor is Dr. Lomenhearth, and she runs the clinic. And the beauty of this clinic is it's once every 3 months, and you go, you sit in a room, and specialists come in every 20 minutes or so. People come from all over to come to this clinic.
Really?
And they only, because we don't have that particular insurance, we pay out of pocket, and it's $250. That's it. For a half day visit to see all of those experts.
Oh my God.
And Dr. Lomenhearth, I will email her. She'll respond in 10 minutes.
Really?
She answers her pages.
Wow.
She's always there when you need her.
to talk more about Emma.
Emma.
And you are so amazing. You named Emma, and it stands for E-M-M-A.
Yes. It stands for Every Moment Matters Always. Uh-huh. And this guy woke me up at 4 a.m. and said, I have the name. And I said, all right, it better be one of my top 10 choices. But it was, and it was Emma, when he told me what it stood for, Every Moment Matters Always. And he had just been diagnosed.
Oh, wow.
I thought, you know what? This would be a great way to honor her. She is so much like him.
Wow.
They are cut from the same cloth. Two peas in a pod.
Okay.
She's so verbal. Well, you're not that verbal anymore, but you're pretty wordy in your writing.
Yeah.
But Jason used to say that he felt that in a way he was transferring his powers to her. So when lost his ability to walk, she was learning how to walk.
Oh,
when he was losing his speech, she was learning how to speak.
Wow.
She's never seen Jason any other way but this.
Right.
So she doesn't think it's weird or sees him as different. She really adapts to him.
Dad.
Yes, just her dad. Yes. Just her dad.
Oh, so cool.
Yes, it's a very, very cool connection.
That's awesome.
Yes. When he first got sick, I thought, oh my gosh, how is he going to be a father?
Mm-hmm.
How is he going to influence her? But it's amazing, even though he can't talk, she really gets it. They bond in their own special
language.
Way,
right.
You know,
exactly,
they share every morning when I'm feeding them, they share applesauce and I feed her and I feed him and I feed her, you know, and he always says, who gets the first bite? And my daughter goes, Emma, you know, and he'll never eat the last bite. I'll always just give it to Emma. It's so sweet. It's very, very
That's
sweet.
Wonderful.
Yeah. He's having lots of difficulty with his fine motors, controlling his wheelchair, so typing. If you see his blog, it takes him a very long time just to get a few letters.
Right.
So eye gaze is awesome. Yeah. It's basically controlled by his eye gaze. He just has to look at the letter or the word on the screen and then blink to select it.
Then
speak, and it speaks for you. It actually can control your TV.
Wow.
It can change channels for you.
Yes.
Yep. Do the volume control. And you can get right on the internet, check your email that way. He can write his memoir that way.
Well, I type with my mouth with a stick to work on my computer.
And oh my gosh.
It's very tedious. But that's wonderful. I didn't
know. Oh, it's amazing.
That.
It's
cool.
It's amazing technology.
Yeah.
Everything takes so much effort.
Yeah.
But Jason is committed,
right.
You know, he's really committed to being as independent as he can.
I want to thank you guys so very much for really taking the effort to coming and coming to see us and visit with us. And you guys are awesome, and we really want to keep in touch with you. And
thank you for giving us the opportunity to speak about this.
Thank you.
Really appreciate it.
Thank you, Jason. And thank you so very much. Until next time, I'm Donna Yeager with On the Move. Have a great day.